Hi, my name is Jesper Pedersen. I'm proud to announce to you today a new YouTube video series that we're going to be putting out. The video series is going to be about Qt widget development. Not just the widget set itself, now everything involved in doing good widget development. So I will very likely talk about gamma ray. I'm likely going to talk about tools like Qt Creator and Qt Designer and give you my best tips for being proficient with these tools. And of course, I am going to share with you a lot of my finest code. Well, as fine as it gets when I write it, at least. Snippets that you might use in your own projects. So stay tuned. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB. I'll start the technical side now. I will introduce you to a little friend of ours in Qt Designer, namely the QGridLayout. It's very useful to use a QGridLayout, but it's also sometimes a bit troublesome. I'll show you four tricks, well, four ways of working with Qt Designer that can make your life just a tiny little bit easier. First, I'll show you how to actually create widgets that span multiple columns and multiple rows inside of a grid layout in Qt Designer. Second, I'll show you how you can drop a widget onto a single pixel. So you have the problem that sometimes your layout squeezes a subset of the layout into just being one pixel high. How do you hit that one pixel? I'll also show you how the the object inspector on the right side, the topmost rightmost side of your Qt Designer, how you can actually see the current element in there. That is the one that you have selected in your design area. And finally, I'm going to show you how can you actually get something appended to the end of a grid layout. Sometimes that can actually be more difficult than you think. Let's create a simple layout. I'll use two labels, one, two. I'll use two line edits. Line edits, there we are, one, two. And I'll put them into a layout. There we are. Not like this, that was the wrong layout. This layout, of course. I want a checkbox in there too. And let's just find the checkbox. Let's add it somewhere here, like there, for example. And the checkbox has a very long label. A very long label. Okay, let me review my user interface. It looks weird that the checkbox isn't in column one, doesn't it? So let's drag it over there. Column one. Now it looks weird that the line edits are that there's so much space between the line edits and the text labels there. So what I really want is my very long labeled checkbox to span both columns. It's not that difficult, but it's one of those features that you need to know about. So you select the item, and now you simply drag it very intuitively, really, over the next column, and now it spans multiple columns. That's one thing that bothers me in this layout, namely that the grid layout itself isn't laid out on its parent. So let's do that right away, shall we? That isn't that difficult. I'll select the background. I'll say like this layout here. And possibly I want the elements to be pushed towards the top. So let me take the vertical spacer here and put that at the bottom like this. Okay, now to the next part. What I really would like to see is three radio buttons between the label and line edit pairs. Why? Oh, come on, give me a break. I just want it. So I take my radio button up here, I'll put it in there, goes well. I'll put it, take the next one, I'll put it in say here. And now I'll take the third one and I'll put it in between here. There is a slight problem that now I actually got a third column in here. That wasn't really what I wanted, because now we're back to the problem with the label and the line edit being far apart. So of course I could take my radio button and put it over in that cell. Oh yeah, I can't put it in that cell. Let me take them entirely away again. Okay, I'll delete them. There we are. And delete them. What I really need here is a horizontal layout in that cell over here. There. And now I have a horizontal layout. I can put my two labels, my two radio buttons in here. But let's admit it, that doesn't look exactly right either. What I really want is the radio button to be evenly spaced out between or in the space available horizontally. So I'll delete them all again here and delete this one, and they are entirely gone now. What I want to do is to take a horizontal layout and drag it over here in between those lines. And now I want my radio button to be dropped on that horizontal layout. That's easy. Just take my radio button, and without shaking at all, I need to hit that one pixel somewhere where it actually hits it. It seems like I'm in luck today, because it seems like I actually hit it there, except I didn't. It's actually the layout you can see sitting above here. So no luck for me today. See, the trick to do this is not to try and hit that one pixel, because if you try to do that, your life is going to be miserable really soon. What you want to do is hit it on the layout menu over here. So if I drop it on the layout menu over here, then it goes into this layout menu. Now, of course, I have multiple pixels to hit on. And of course, again, I can take the border here and I can take my border here and I can resize it in. And this time I was more lucky than I had asked for, because I wanted to show you once again that I hit the checkbox here and tried to resize that in, and I started dragging again, which is not what I want. What I really, really want is to hit Again, it's difficult to hit that one pixel, right? So what I do is I go over here and I hit my radio, my horizontal box over there, and now I can resize it back in here. Jesper, it's super obvious that you are no more than 18 years old and you have really, really good eyes. Because on you can tell the difference between those slightly different gray colors. I can't. Can you help me, Jesper? And yes, I can. And thank you for recognizing my age. Let's look at the code. And you got in here. So what I'm talking about here is that grayish color. Well, when I don't hover my mouse over it, at least. That grayish color that you see here and the grayish color for these items. It's actually worse if I select one of the radio buttons. You can see now it's actually this item that is hovered over here now again, but it's not because that it's the current one. It's just where my cursor hovers over. So can you see the difference between that gray, and that gray? Well, maybe you can, at least I can't anymore. And it's even worse when you have a real-sized hierarchy of elements where that sidebar can be many pages long. So here's the trick. You need to give that sidebar the input focus. And you do so by simply clicking on, say, the header up here. And now you can see that it became light blue here. Of course, if I go over here and I click on an item over here, then this area will take the keyboard input focus. And I now need to click over that again. Yes, I would have loved for the Qt company to hear what I've been asking all this year. Can I have it in blinking red, the current item? Nobody wanted to listen to me, obviously, so at least this is a workaround for you. The final thing I'm going to show you today is how you actually add a new widget at the bottom of a layout. What? That sounds super simple. You just drop it there at the bottom. Well, let me show you how simple it is not necessarily. I take, say, a push button this time, and I want to drop it here at the bottom of the layout. So I move over here, and I drop it, and it's at the bottom of the layout, right? What? Ooh, yeah, it does look like it's taking the full site. And even worse, if I go over here, I can be validated. Let me just resize a column for you here. That the push button is actually sitting as a child off the form underneath the grid layout. And underneath here, I mean physically underneath, not inside the grid layout. So obviously, I did not manage to append it. But if I drag it in here, you can see there's clearly a drop point here. and there's the drop point up there. So the drop point up there must be what gets me into. Nope. It's actually not that difficult either, but you just need to be aware of it. When you drop it over there, make sure that you can see the whole grid layout changing background color. See all the dots inside of the elements went away. So now I'm dropping inside. Let me show you a small peculiarity. I can't explain why, but if I take here and I drop it on the first column, because that this one spans multiple columns, it actually only allows me to add to the not the last, but the one before the last element. Peculiar. Over here it works. I'm sure I found a bug in Qt Designer. So, That's it for our very first pilot episode of this new YouTube series on programming with Qt Widget. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that you'll come back for more. Until then, have a great time.